When Jacob was born, as the nurse handed him to me, I immediately said, what's wrong with his leg? It didn't have any skin on his left leg from his upper thigh to his toes.
16-month-old Jacob has the serious dystrophic form of epidermolysis bullosa, or EB.
They call them butterfly children. His skin breaks down really easily with any friction. He gets blisters, he gets damage. And on top of that, that damage doesn't repair very well.
The cause? His skin is lacking collagen 7A.
Effectively, there's like Velcro that holds our skin together, and he's missing that Velcro because he's missing that protein. The condition can become quite debilitating.
And makes him susceptible to a lot of other complications as well, which can lead to kind of our fatal condition later in life.
While Jacob suffers the most severe form of EB, most patients like Nina and her youngest son, Otto, have the less severe EB simplex.
When you have EB, you just have to reset your expectations about what life might be like.
But try telling that to 14-year-old Otto when it comes to playing footy.
My feet are normally fine throughout the game, but then the consequences are after the game. I start to form blisters under my feet and get scabs and cuts. If my feet are really bad because of the game, I can sometimes miss school.
At other times, he has to use a wheelchair.
How are we going, Otto?
Yeah, good. I've got a great group of mates who help me get around the school and get to classes.
When we go on holidays, one of the boys pushes Otto and Jeff, my husband, pushes me, so we have to travel quite differently to most families.
And the weather is always a consideration.
We're going as a family to New Zealand. We picked it because it will be nice and cold. Anything above 21 degrees, he can just spontaneously blister under his bandages, so the snow it is.
I sometimes think of the people living in Queensland or Darwin or WA. I think at least in Melbourne we have a decent winter. I never thought I'd be proud of Melbourne's winter, but I am.
But even in Melbourne, looking after Jacob is a mammoth operation.
We have a significant NDIS package for Jacob. We have probably 4 carers here every morning doing various things to just get everything done. He sees about 17 different specialists. If you imagine how many appointments that is, kind of every week, it's a lot.
It's a very terrible disease, but these patients are very courageous, and working with them can be very inspiring.
Peter Marenkovich is a dermatologist and researcher at Stanford University in the US. And after decades of work, his team has developed a treatment for dystrophic EB.
It basically is just a gel that goes directly on your skin, on your wounds. This gel delivers the collagen 7 gene directly to the skin cells, and then it makes the skin stronger, putting the glue back so that the skin doesn't blister afterwards.
In its commercial form, Vyjuvek is made by Krystal Biotech, and the US Food and Drug Administration approved its use 3 months ago.
Eventually, we hope that Krystal Biotech will apply to the TGA and we'll be able to get it here in Australia. But what I've been told is that TGA is painfully slow with these things.
The Therapeutic Goods Administration, or TGA, approves drug use in Australia, and they tell us they have not received an application from Krystal Biotech to register Vyjuvek for the treatment of epidermolysis bullosa. Meanwhile, Jacob and others like him may be eligible to access this treatment earlier via the government's special access scheme, but none of this comes cheaply.
It would cost over $1 million a year for Jacob to have access to this drug, and there's 80 others in the country that will want access as well, and that's every year. It's not a one-off therapy. Yeah. You need to apply it every week or 2 weeks for it to work.
The treatment only works for dystrophic EB, but celebrities like Chris Hemsworth and Eddie Vedder are backing research into other forms of the disease that are being funded by groups like EB Research Partnership.
You know, I can't help but think about how much those living with EB can teach us. Lessons in humility, grace, and perhaps most of all, bravery.
The health minister might want to pay attention. I mean, if you think about the Labor government's promise, they've talked about supporting rare disease. Well, right now, we have a drug available in the world that can part cure a rare disease.
He is a happy kid.
Jacob is a happy kid.
You you can't imagine the resilience of Jacob and other children that have this condition.
Everybody loves him. Yeah. You know, he has this infectious energy, Jacob. And that, honestly, that makes it a bit easier, doesn't it? Just how happy this kid is. Yeah.
Such a beautiful little boy, and he shouldn't have to endure 4 hours of bandage changes every single day when there's a medication available, $1 million. I mean, that's obviously not affordable for families.
No.
But all it would take would be some government official to go to their house and see him being bathed, and the pain that he's in, just awful.
Yeah, so obviously the process for something like this is for it to be added to the pharmaceutical benefits scheme. That would be well after the TGA approves it, so lots of processes involved there, but doctors obviously making the point that this would make a big, huge difference, you know, for someone like Jacob.
And some EB charities say that the drug could be approved by as early as 2024, so there's some good news there.